We found a few people really early on who were really engaged and really excited about what we were doing, and that was really great, and that really sowed the seeds to then grow the team further. My name is Sasha. I'm one of the co-founders and the CEO of a startup called Unitary, which is building technology to understand online content and help make the internet safer.
Yosh.AI is developing AI voice assistants. And what we are doing is like developing, let's say, Google assistants for companies, meaning that we automate communication between companies and end users. So we work with retailers, banks, insurance companies.
Were you doing something similar before?
No, that's my first experience with AI, but let's say I understood it from the business side, but I had no idea how to then build a solution actually in AI and technology world. So I had to learn a lot.
Amazing.
How about you?
Yeah, so before starting my company, I was actually in academia doing something totally different. I was doing a PhD in theoretical physics.
Physics, wow.
Looking at black holes. But I realized that although it was really interesting and kind of intellectually really interesting, I wanted to work on solving problems that I felt could have more of an impact to our society. And I felt like starting a company was a really good way to do that. And the idea that we've got and the problem we're working on today, which is around online safety and how we can sort of automate the process of content moderation by building AI models to automatically detect harmful content online. And we're looking particularly at video.
Sasha, so you met your co-founder. You guys have this amazing idea. And what do you do next? How did you build your team?
Yeah, we sort of set about to raise money. And then after that, the first thing we wanted to do was start building the teams to have people to actually start working on this. And I guess we realized we needed to hire our first person when we just felt that we couldn't do it ourselves. There were people asking us of things we just didn't have enough bandwidth to do or couldn't do. And so we sort of set about trying to figure out what does our early team need to look like. For us, that was very heavily sort of machine learning focused, trying to find people who were sort of experts in the space we were going after, so in video, but also thinking about engineering generally. Like if we're going to process thousands, millions of videos, we need to have sort of robust software engineering infrastructure. And we just started posting on job boards, trying to meet people through our networks. Actually, our network was really, really helpful. Mm-hmm. Trying to find just people who know of other people who might be interested in startups. But we found a few people really early on who were really engaged and really excited about what we were doing. And that was really great. And that really set, sowed the seeds to then grow the team further. What about you? When did you hire your first employee? And
about 5 years ago. So first there was an idea, more like a business idea, really, because I understand better that part, let's say, not the science part in AI. Then I thought exactly, okay, I need an AI team. Okay, it's great, but obviously who do I need and what kind of qualities and competencies? So my first two hires were engineers. So we started designing at the beginning. We use, and we still actually are using Google technology. And with this technology, we developed the product. And then with time, I was looking for someone like a kind of co-founder that actually will build this AI solution or expert and will have this expertise to support me. So now I have absolutely amazing late co-founder, I would say, that joined me. He came from a big company and he also felt that he can have more impact on like everyday development of the product. Yes, and for me, why it worked and why we have such an amazing team, it's we've started with an idea for the product and then I had no idea how to do it since I don't have this skill. So I had to put trust in them and just let them to really create this product. And I was just giving them more like a feedback, insights, what is really needed by the end user or by our clients like companies. So
I think something I felt when we started hiring people was how do we set up the right tone maybe or the right culture for the company? And people talk about company culture all the time. And then you don't really know what it means. And then when we were hiring the first people, I remember thinking, well, I want them to love working here because they can't leave. But also I want them to do amazing work and I want them to feel empowered to do that work so I don't have to sort of check everything. And I think that was quite a hard sort of journey to go on a little bit. And I found that every stage, when you sort of add more people, there's a time when people are new and then there's the original core group. And there's this sort of time when you've got to transfer knowledge to the new people. And that's always a really interesting dynamic when everyone's learning and it feels a bit out of control again and then sort of settles down. So it's been a very interesting process. Have you found it difficult bringing on people? And
I don't think so. It's maybe I realized that I didn't have really any choice, right? Since I don't have the skills. So I had to trust people. I think I was guided really by my intuition a lot. Yes. So, and more about like this chemistry that was with some people, you find it so easy to talk and it just goes so easily, right? So I think, especially in the beginning, this is a crucial part, because what you are doing, it's very innovative. What we are doing, it's innovative. So we don't expect people to know, right, and have these skills, but we expect them to have this attitude and this openness really to learn and to go through this journey and go through all the downfalls and just address them and just get up and keep going. And you know, we fail, we get up, and then we just keep going. And how is it for you?
Yeah, it's similar. I think at the beginning, especially, you know where you want to get to, but you don't know the exact detail. There's so many unanswered questions. So there's this whole journey of pivoting, moving around, doing the wrong thing, wasting loads of time on something that you don't need to do. And it's constantly, as you said, picking yourself up again, realizing it's okay. That's part of the process. It's the journey. And not getting too waylaid by the fact that you've done the wrong thing and not trying to have all the answers. I think there's some people really thrive in that environment, and sort of finding that core group of people has felt constantly like what we're looking for and quite hard to find, I think. What do you feel is your leadership style?
Well, I guess there is a lot of trust, hopefully, and a lot of positive message coming from me, I hope. And also, I hope, enough appreciation to our team's effort. And I think people really need it. I guess sometimes I am tough because I have to be. Yes, we have to, like, I think it is required. So overall, I believe the most important is to show people that they can achieve way more than they thought they could. So I saw it from our first employee, and then I just keep seeing it and I keep hearing it that they wouldn't even dare to do that if I wouldn't encourage them. So this is very rewarding for me to see how people are really growing.
Do you think that sort of evolved, or your leadership style's evolved as the company's grown?
Absolutely, yes. I think it's very different, you know, when there is like one person and like two, three, four people, it's very casual, I think. And, you know, it's a lot of exchange of ideas, information. It's a daily conversation, I would say. And when the team grows, it's sharing the long-term vision, also giving like more goals than really tasks. So definitely I am growing and I'm learning a lot. So hopefully it seems that a lot of people is happy and fulfilled and they are doing great jobs. So it seems that it's working. And how do you see yourself as a leader?
Good question. I guess I don't really know. I think I'm very energetic as a leader and very, very positive. I think it's definitely, as you said, changed and evolved as we've grown. And there was for me, the shift happened when we went from 5 to 10 people. Because when we were just 5 people, we could be totally collaborative about everything and just sit together in a room and talk through decisions. And so it didn't feel like I had to be such a leader in that way. And then as soon as we moved to 10, 15 people, suddenly we couldn't just communicate. And the flow of information between me and everyone else changed really. And so then I felt I had to sort of step up a bit and put in place processes for people to like get information, but also start thinking about, as you said, goal setting rather than tasks, and how can you delegate effectively rather than just decide altogether what to do. So I found that a really interesting change. But how have you managed with motivating your team through difficult periods?
I can talk about, obviously, COVID times. So I think that these difficult times, let's say, are times when you need to show more human side of yourself, I think, and really being more supportive, more understanding, pay more attention to human feelings. We were lucky enough that, obviously, we moved online like everyone else. But overall for us, I think we went through this quite okay. And how was it for you?
I think COVID itself was actually okay for us as well. We were lucky in that we raised money just before COVID. So we just, from a sort of financial point of view, we were secure and we were in the luxurious position of being able to hire people in that time. But even so, I think people felt stressed because they didn't know what was going on with, you know, the world. And so like you, I think we tried to stay like really close as a team and do more virtual sort of team building things. I remember we did a virtual pizza making workshop where we all just made pizzas and a few things like that. I think made a big difference to bring everyone together and have shared experiences when we were all sort of living very strange lives in new COVID world.
We also added this daily meetings at 9 a.m. So I think for a lot of people, it was good, you know. Yeah, just small things that put more like routine in our lives and in their lives. I think that was really important. I believe that, you know, we get stronger only when we go through the tough times, right? If there's only successes, so we wouldn't know who we really are if we wouldn't deal with this together. So I think we created a great team, and also we built culture, and we actually kept a lot of things that we created during this time, and we just keep going, even though now we have half-time office and half-time in online.
Nice. We actually stayed fully remote since the pandemic and now a completely remote first organization. So we realized what was really great about being remote is that we could have employees around Europe or around the world. And so then started hiring internationally, which has been really wonderful to have people from different cultures and bring different experiences to the team. And so now we're sort of leaning much more heavily on those virtual shared experiences. Something I found so inspiring about what you've been saying today is how you've managed to bootstrap your company, just sort of starting with just yourself and your idea and then slowly grow it so organically. And I think that's really inspiring.
Thank you. What I really liked about you and your story overall is that you found the courage to go from science world into business world, which is, at the end, these are very different worlds, but you also found the way to combine these two worlds, yes, and do it with all this positive attitude, which I think is a part of your success to drive this enthusiasm, I guess, from your team and this performance and get these great results that you guys are getting. So congratulations.
Thanks.